In the previous video, I showed what this works out to be, and we can write that as 1/2 h bar squared over 2, or h bar over 2 squared. Now, separately, other videos have talked about how to actually calculate what these RMS deviations are, and again, remember that we have to define it for a specific state. And so the deviation for the operator SX for a spin-up state in Z is going to be h bar over 2, and for the spin-y state, it will be the same thing. So now we can look at our uncertainty principle, and we can plug in the left and right side. So on the right, on the left side, we have h bar over 2 coming from that first RMS deviation, and then we have h bar over 2 coming from the second RMS deviation. And then what we're doing is basically verifying that this is true, saying, is this greater than or equal to 1/2 times what we calculated over here, which, again, if we write it this way, h bar squared over 2. So if you notice, what we actually have is that h bar over 2 squared is greater than or equal to h bar over 2 squared. So is that true? Yes. In fact, they're equal. Now there's a conclusion that you can actually take from this, and that is that this is going to be one of our minimum uncertain states. And obviously you would say, well wait, there's actually a lot of uncertainty here. But the point is, we could have actually calculated a different spin state that maybe this side is bigger and that this side doesn't actually get bigger. But in this case, this is going to be as good as it gets. So oftentimes we're working with a minimally uncertain state, so one where this is an equivalency, but it doesn't have to be. So if there's a situation where you are just setting these equal to solve, that's fine. There are going to be lots of times that we use that. But do keep in mind that we can construct states that are actually worse than that, where a deviation is worse than what we would just get from this commutation expectation value. So what you could have done here is actually use any two of these, if you knew that this was the minimum uncertain state, to set this equal and calculate one of the three values, or you can get a limiting case on one of these three values. Effectively, it can be this size or bigger or smaller, depending on what you're calculating. Really conceptually, the important thing to see here is that neither of these terms could be zero. That one of the ways that we conceptually use this uncertainty principle is to see if this must be greater than or equal to a number. If either of these were zero, then this could become zero. And, or this would, side would be zero regardless of what the other one is. So this is a really important conceptual conclusion, that as long as the right side is not zero, neither of the terms on the left side can be zero. So again, I hope that calculating the pieces of these makes sense. One of the challenges in this class is that initially the homework problem might just be calculate the RMS deviation of this operator for this state, or calculate the commutation relationship of these two operators. But then once you get to the uncertainty principle, you actually have to calculate all three of those things before you do anything with it. So do notice that we keep building and building and building.